Christmas, and so perhaps feeding the witch's magic like basilisk would provide a better alternative. Finally, this may be how he harnesses the magic of the taverns during the Day of Unity. So, unfortunately, he runs out of magic to drain and needs to find more in order to continue living our life safely in the human world. So Lewis helps her out, suggesting to go look for things he has left behind from her visits to Connecticut. She had apparently been frequenting a cafe under the alias of Marilyn. Very interestingly, this is the name of one of Grandpa Stan's ex-wives, who he divorced from only 48 hours after it turned out she only wanted to marry him to try and steal his car. Stan describes her to be the spitting image of Ida, down to the one sharp tooth and the same shirt. She even apparently left through a door into a canyon. This connection is made even more likely by multiple allusions to the Owl House and Lost Legends. Big thanks to Gus on my Discord for pointing this out to me. Anyway, as it turns out, through some cool summer camp friends, Marilyn's Texas Hold'em cards have ended up in the museum curator's hands. So we meet the curator and he sucks ass. I can't believe I thought he was hot for a second. He's basically Ronaldo from Steven Universe, except maybe even worse somehow. Just like Ronaldo, he gets the truth about things half-right, but his theories devolve into tranquil territory.
Which is indeed makes far real. And they're all set for Mars to harvest humanity to power their time machine.
This dude spends way too much time on Reddit. He even has a certificate for being a goddamn flat earther. I actually predicted in my previous video that someone was researching witches and monitoring the shack. So that's what he needs. There's not too much else to say about him, but he does give us a very interesting lore drop. Perhaps the biggest reveal of the episode is that, according to the curator, a witch lured two brothers into the demon realm in the 1600s. We actually see statues of them early in the episode. Now, it's extremely likely that one of them is Philip Wetterbane. Seeing as Gwendolyn mentioned, there only ever being one other human living in Bonesboro, it'd be far too coincidental for it to have been some other human. So I wonder, is one of the brothers Philip and the other Bellows? Or is Bellows Philip and there's a brother figure we don't know about? I'm actually pretty convinced Bellows is one of them, and if you recall, he said his